LGBT emperors of ancient Rome. In ancient Greece and the Roman Empire, homosexual relationships were an accepted and common practice. In these hyper-masculine societies, the male form was revered for its physical perfection, while women's virtues were jealously guarded to ensure the legitimacy of children. In Greece, romantic and sometimes sexual relationships between older and younger men were seen as an initiation rite. The Romans modeled themselves after Greece in most things, but had strong feelings that a Roman citizen should always play the dominant, never submissive role in a homosexual relationship. Prominent citizens sought out enslaved men, prostitutes, and entertainers to fulfill their sexual desires. Enslaved boys would sometimes be castrated in an attempt to keep them docile and immature for the pleasure of their dominant male lovers. Though uncommon, marriages between men were not unheard of in ancient Rome. They included many of the traditional elements of a Roman wedding, including a dowry, and the man acting as the bride would wear a veil. Here are the stories of 8 Roman emperors whose attraction to the masculine form was particularly renowned. Julius Caesar. At 16, Caesar became a high priest of Jupiter and married Cornelia, who bore him a daughter. When his uncle came out the worse in a rivalry with a fellow general, Caesar decided to make himself scarce and joined the army fighting in Asia. He was sent on a diplomatic mission to visit King Nicomedes of Bithynia in modern-day Turkey. Caesar remained at Nicomedes' court much longer than necessary, and rumors of a romantic relationship between the two circled. It was said that Caesar was now queen of Bithynia. When he returned home to Rome and launched his political career, hearsay and innuendo dogged him. It was not so much that he had had a homosexual relationship that was seen as insulting, but that he had played the submissive role to a foreign ruler. Caesar was a brilliant military commander and was the first Roman general to cross the Rhine River and the English Channel in his mission to conquer new lands for Rome. These achievements gave him unrivaled power and threatened the existing power structure. The Senate ordered him to step down from his military command and return to Rome. He instead invaded the capital and took control of the government, naming himself dictator for life. He was married 2 more times, had an infamous affair with Egyptian queen Cleopatra VII, and became a notorious womanizer. As ruler, Caesar mandated a great deal of reform. He gave Roman citizenship to residents of far-flung regions of the empire, initiated land reform, and supported veterans. He also introduced the Julian calendar, which was used throughout Europe until the 16th century. On the Ides, or 15th of March, Caesar was stabbed to death by rival senators. He is not known to have any male lovers besides Nicomedes, but Julius Caesar's sexuality has been a topic of debate among historians for centuries. Contemporary statesman Curio the Elder said that Caesar was every woman's man and every man's woman. Whether this was just a twisted political insult or based in truth may never be known, but it is an interesting story. Emperor Tiberius. When Tiberius was 5 years old, his mother divorced his father in order to marry the future Emperor Augustus. Tiberius married his childhood friend Vipsania, and the couple had a happy marriage. But when her father died, Emperor Augustus demanded that Tiberius divorce his beloved wife and marry her stepmother, who also happened to be the emperor's daughter. The new couple were miserable together, and Julia did nothing to hide her numerous affairs. Tiberius once ran into Vipsania and broke down into tears, begging for her forgiveness. But their families made sure that they never saw each other again. Tiberius embarked on a successful military career and conquered many northern territories. But he walked away from power and retired to the island of Rhodes. This was partly to get away from his wife, who had become notorious for her promiscuity. Her imperial father put a stop to her behavior by exiling her and forcing several of her lovers to commit suicide. When Augustus's 2 teenage grandsons and heirs died, Tiberius was called back to Rome as heir to the throne. At 55, Tiberius was named emperor, a position he never wanted and was loath to take. He was described as the gloomiest of men and let the Senate do most of the ruling. He preferred to escape to his villa on the island of Capri, which he filled with erotic art depicting a variety of homo and heterosexual acts. He entertained young men and women and had a group of boys called his little fishes who accompanied him when he swam and were trained to lick and nibble him under the water. Tiberius's palace of sexual luxuries bestowed upon the island of Capri a reputation as a resort of royal indulgence, especially of a homosexual nature, that exists to this day. After 22 years spent barely on the throne, Tiberius died at 77 and passed the empire to his adopted grandson, Caligula, who was even more infamous for his sexual exploits. Emperor Nero. Nero became emperor after his mother, Agrippina the Younger, poisoned her husband, Emperor Claudius, to make room for her son. She dominated the teenage emperor and possibly had a sexual relationship with him for the first 5 years of his reign. Tired of his mother's overbearing, Nero had her murdered. The emperor was married to 3 different women and 2 men in public ceremonies. His first male spouse, Pythagoras, was a free man and wine steward to whom Nero played the bride. After the death of his second wife, Poppaea, Nero married a young man, Sporus, who bore a striking resemblance to her. Nero had Sporus castrated in an attempt to preserve his youthful feminine appearance. Nero was a lover of arts, built theaters, and promoted athletic games. He even appeared in public as an actor, musician, and chariot racer. He invested in a great many public works and was loved by the common people, but paid for everything with taxes on the wealthy and gained their animosity. By age 30, he had lost the support of the military, who proclaimed Galba as the new emperor. Nero fled the city, and when he learned that he had been tried and condemned to death in absentia, he decided to kill himself. Panicked and losing his nerve, he begged one of his companions to set an example by committing suicide first. The deposed emperor finally forced his secretary to kill him. His spouse, Sporus, was with him at the end. He fell into the hands of a succession of 3 of Nero's enemies. The first 2 used him as a wife. The 3rd planned to use Sporus as a victim in a gladiator show. Rather than facing this humiliating public execution, the 20-year-old killed himself. Nero is most famous as a tyrant who did many despicable deeds, such as kick his pregnant wife Poppaea to death and play a fiddle while Rome burned to make room to expand his palace. However, modern historians believe that these stories were put about by his political adversaries. There is little evidence that he killed his wife, who more likely died in childbirth. He was away from the city when Rome caught fire, as it regularly did, and in fact he returned quickly to head up relief operations. After Nero was overthrown, many commoners whispered that he might not be dead and hoped that he would return to rule again. Emperor Galba. Galba served as governor of Africa and later Hispania, modern-day Spain and Portugal. His sexual preference was for men with hard bodies and past their prime. He had no desire for women, but he was married to Aemilia Lepida and fathered 2 sons out of duty. His wife and children died young, and he remained a widower for the rest of his life, despite being pursued by the Dowager Empress, Agrippina the Younger, who would have been an impressive political match. In 68 AD, Galba and other prominent Romans rebelled against the Emperor Nero, who then committed suicide. Galba seized the throne at the age of 70. His rule was marred by corruption. He took property from citizens and failed to pay the army. 7 months into his reign, the imperial guard toppled Galba's statues and demanded that a new emperor be chosen. They murdered Galba and his advisors and placed their heads on spikes. 3 other emperors followed him in quick succession in what became known as the Year of 4 Emperors. Emperor Domitian. Domitian was the son and brother of successive emperors. He was excessively handsome and had a successful military career. He fell in love with Domitia Longia and convinced her husband to divorce her so that he could marry her instead. They had one son who died in childhood. Domitian briefly exiled his wife, possibly because she did not bear him any more sons, but they soon reconciled. He became emperor at the age of 30. Enter Irenaeus, a young enslaved man from Greece who was so comely that as a boy he had been castrated in order to gain a place as a royal cupbearer. The eunuch became a favorite of Domitian. He was devoted to his master, and poets describe their relationship as a marriage. Domitian granted his beloved his freedom, and Irenaeus made a statement by cutting his hair short in public, signifying that he was a man. The emperor was very sensitive about his hair and began wearing wigs to hide his baldness. His 15-year reign was a period of stability after significant turmoil in the empire. He strengthened the economy, expanded the empire northward, and rebuilt much of the capital damaged by fire during the reign of Nero. He held the reins of power with a firm hand and did much to stamp out corruption in the government. He was obsessed with controlling the morality of the people and dictated that all should adhere to traditional religious practices and worship the royal family as divine. He burned alive Vestal virgins if they were found to be unchaste, and in sympathy with his eunuch lover, outlawed castrating children. He was popular with the army and public, but despised by the Senate, who plotted to kill him. Domitian was stabbed 8 times by a servant, but the emperor fought back and returned a fatal wound to his assassin. He died at 44. Emperor Hadrian. Hadrian was born in Spain. His father was the first cousin of Emperor Trajan. Trajan liked Hadrian very well and married him to his niece, renowned beauty Vibia Sabina. Hadrian was said to have treated her badly, and the couple had no children. Just before his death, Trajan nominated the 41-year-old Hadrian to replace him. The military and Senate confirmed him as emperor. Hadrian put to death 4 senators who had opposed him, and the Senate never forgave him. He halted expansion of the empire in favor of promoting stability and unification among the varied cultures under his rule. He visited almost every corner of the empire in pursuit of these goals. He also secured the borders of his domain and is known for building Hadrian's Wall along the northern border of Britannia. He also built the Parthenon and the Temple of Venus and Roma in Rome, as well as the Serapeum of Alexandria in Egypt. Hadrian had a romantic relationship with a Greek youth of humble birth named Antinous. Hadrian's beloved traveled the empire with him. They enjoyed hunting together and killed a lion in Egypt. His beloved drowned in the Nile at the age of 20, and Hadrian was devastated. He deified his dead lover and had him worshipped as a god, creating a cult in his name. Statues of the young man were erected throughout the empire, and a city was founded near the place of his death, named Antinopolis. There was considerable controversy surrounding Antinous's demise. Some believed that he had offered himself as a sacrifice to the gods to ensure Hadrian's prosperity. Hadrian ruled the empire for 21 years of relative peace and prosperity. He died at 62. Emperor Elagabalus. Elagabalus became emperor at the age of 14 after his grandmother, Julia Maissa, incited a revolt against the previous men in power. The young ruler had no regard for Roman religious traditions or sexual taboos. He replaced the chief god, Jupiter, with a deity named Elagabalus, and forced prominent Romans to participate in religious rites over which he presided. He was married 5 times in 4 years. His second wife was a Vestal virgin whom he corrupted and abandoned. His most stable relationship was with his chariot driver, Hierocles, whom he referred to as his husband. He lavished favors on his male lovers and even married one of them in a public ceremony, where the emperor played the part of the bride. Elagabalus enjoyed painting his eyes, plucking his body hair, and wearing wigs, then prostituting himself in taverns and brothels. Eventually, this became inconvenient, so he set up a room in the imperial palace where he would solicit men for sex. He would stand nude at the door and in a sweet, melting voice entice passers-by who were, of course, specially instructed to play their part. He would then brag to the prostitutes of Rome about how many lovers he had and the high prices he commanded. Ilagabalus preferred to be called a lady and wore women's clothes, wigs, and costumes. He offered vast sums to any physician who could perform a sexual reassignment surgery on him. After 4 years on the throne, popular support began to shift away from the emperor towards his cousin Alexander. At a public event, soldiers cheered for Alexander and ignored the emperor. Outraged, he ordered the execution of anyone who took part in this insubordination. In response, the soldiers attacked him. His mother clung tightly to him, and she too was murdered by the crowd. Following his death, his lover, Hierocles, was executed, and records of Elagabalus' rule were expunged. Statues of him were recarved with the face of his successor, Emperor Severus Alexander. Emperor Constans. Constans was the youngest son of Emperor Constantine the Great. He was 14 when his father died, and his brothers Constantine II and Constantinus II and their cousin Dalmatius divided the empire between themselves and disposed of all their relatives who could have a claim to the throne. Naturally, the new emperors squabbled over their portions, and Constans defeated Constantine, adding his brother's territory to his own. He then led a successful conquest against the Franks and visited Britain. Contemporaries wrote that Constans indulged in great vice. He had a reputation for taking handsome barbarian hostages of war as lovers. However, under pressure from leaders of the new and growing Christian religion, he decreed that homosexual marriage be outlawed. Constans never married, and by 27 he was dominated by his male favorites. He lost the support of the army, and General Magnentius declared himself emperor. Without support, Constans fled to Gaul, but was tracked down and murdered while seeking sanctuary in a temple. If you want to learn more about LGBT royal history, check out the other videos on my channel. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, comment your thoughts, and check out my other royal history videos. If you really want to help, please consider supporting me on Patreon. A link is in the description. Thank you for watching!